this Zant Cap coming back with a second video for the Broncos offensive playbook. This time we're going to jump into the gun formations, and we're going to start off with the gun deuce. The first play we're going to be looking at is the Z dig. What you want to do on this play is you want to take this tight end on the left hand side that's not on a route. You want to move him to the left and put him on a hitch. That's going to free up that X receiver in the middle to get the space in between those guys. Next play we're going to do is the corner strike. And on the corner strike, we're going to be able to move this guy over from right to left, and it's going to free up the route combination I like. We'll put him on a streak, move him to the left, and it's going to free up this X receiver once the guy jumps the flat. So I'm going to go ahead and throw this ball here. He jumps the flat. I like to pass lead it up. Get him about another 5 more yards on that throw. Next play we're going to do is called the inside cross. We're going to flip this play before it even gets to the line. We like the formation a little bit better from right to left. And what we're going to do here is we're also going to put this X on a comeback. It's going to hold that deep receiver. And then we're going to take this A, streak him and put him to the right. Okay, and this is going to get your B receiver open over the middle. You want to throw that a little bit more flat than I did. Obviously, I was able to catch it, but flat will give him a little bit more room to catch and run. All right, next play is going to be the PA comebacks. And we're going to run this play as is. All right, let's see where this play is. All right. And on this play, we're going to hit the tight end over the middle as soon as he clears. So we go ahead and do it here. Again, I should have thrown that ball a little bit more flat. This is a second tight end you're throwing to, so you do want to not have him catch it in traffic. There's the throw right there. Because he's probably got a lesser catch in traffic rating. All right. Your next play is going to be called the PAFL screen. And on this play, what you want to do to get this play a little bit more open is you're going to put your Y on a slant. That opens up the B for you. Alright. We're going to get out of this. We're going to go to the gun dice slot, which we're going to stay in for a little while because I like this series. And the first play we're going to look at in the gun dice slot is going to be the drive trail. But I'm going to flip it to start. I like it better the way it runs that way. Alright. And on the drive trail, first thing we're going to do is we're going to run it as is, and we're going to hit are running back for about 3 to 5 yards on a situational play. Right there, get ourselves some room and go from there. The second way, we're gonna do it flipped the same way. If you look on the right hand side, let's go back to the original play. This play kills cover three buzz, any type of press route. On the right hand side, that route takes an outside release, throw it over the top, and he's just burnt. So you can force your opponent out of the cover three buzz pretty quickly with those type plays. Next play is going to be called the PA seams. We're going to try to get to a tight end in the seam on this play. And show you the play art here. And what you're going to do is you can move your tight end over. And you're going to go ahead, get the motion. And that's the soft spot of that cover three right there in the middle. And he's good to go. I would always go ahead and run this play. See if you take a quick base, any type of running play, but set it up with getting your tight end motion early in the game. So this way they see that look. It gets that linebacker out of there anyways. And then you can go right up the middle. But giving your opponent two different looks sets up that play action a little bit better. The next play is going to be the PA comebacks. And what we're going to do is we're going to flip this as well. Alright, so we're flipping it. And on this play, we're going to take A and... Take A, put him on a streak, put him to the left. That's going to set up that streak comeback look we're looking at already on the left-hand side. Bullet it down right here. And the same exact setup. Move him over, streak him. You're going to hit this Y receiver now. And that A clears the Y out big time for this throw. Alright. Next play is going to be called the PA dagger. It's not in here, so let's go ahead and check it out. We're going to run this one as is, just like any other PA dagger or any type of dagger. There it is. And that's going to have that route combination over the middle. Right there, and keep it in there. All right, next play is gonna be the X under. And we're gonna run this two different ways. The first way is situational. We're just gonna go ahead and get our 3 to 5 yards, depending on what we need. Think this play, the least it's gonna get is about 4, but I wouldn't expect more than 5 or 6 on it. So it goes to the X receiver, and you're gonna run this as is. Cuts underneath, and it catches the ball about the 4 yard mark, so that's why I like to try to run it at the 3 yard or less on the third down. The other way is if you got the right combination, this route again beats this man off of the jam very easily, and it takes the inside release and it kills him. Alright, next play we're going to look at is the PA read. Okay, PA read, okay, right there. And on the PA read rate, you want to put the A on a streak, you want to put the Y on a hitch. That's going to open up your cross angle here with X. Right there. And then we're going to go ahead and do the next play, which is going to be the halfback angle. Alright. On the halfback angle, you want to put the X on a streak, put the Y on an in. Yeah, let's try this again. The X on a streak, the Y on an in. And you want to hit the angle after he clears. Right there. So this, a lot of times people try to do the angle short. This one, you want to do it long. Alright. I'll show it again for you. X on a streak, Y on an in. That's going to clear out your angle route. You're going to stop, throw it, you can lob it, you can do whatever you want. At that point, he's going to be wide open. And you're good to go. Next play is going to be called Strong Flood. Number 81 on your guide. There it is, Strong Flood. On the Strong Flood, you're just going to block your running back, and this play is naturally going to get the X open because of the levels type combination, and he's got a lot of room over there. Those are the type of plays I like to do on a 3rd and 10 type play because of how much separation they have. You don't have to worry about getting popped. Alright, the next play is going to be called the Y shallow cross. This is going to get to your tight end over the middle. Alright. What you want to do is you take your. Wait a second here. I think I got this play mixed up here. Because it doesn't describe the way I want to write it. Let's go ahead and check this play out again here. I think we're looking at the curl slot. Streak. Let's see if this play looks better. Y streak. B streak. X to the right and smart route. And that's going to free over your tight end to the right hand side. Alright. Let's move on. Other play is going to be the X streak here. And you're going to move him to the right. And that's going to free up your A receiver on this play as well. If you got enough time. Which you should. What I like about this formation is that baby motion right there. Gives you the opportunity to do a lot of different things and get more of a tight compressed set because it doesn't motion all the way over. Next play you're going to do is called a corner strike. Corner strike, you're going to put your B on a streak, then you want to motion him to the left here. And he didn't settle, so basically we're having some issues with the him going on a route. Let's go ahead and show it to you. Yeah, make sure your guy settles. So move him over. Because I didn't have him settle, he ended up becoming a blocker, and that really changed the whole route combination. But your X receiver is going to be open once you get him to run his route. Alright. Next play is going to call the Y receiver drag. On this drag play, we're going to get to Douglas on the post. What we're going to do is take the A receiver and streak him and motion him to the left side. That's going to free up your Y receiver over the top. Alright, that's how you throw it short. Now, this play also works if you want to try to air it out for the 30-yard over-the-top bomb type play. This route combination, because the wheel keeps that cornerback on the right hand side honest. So let's see if we can get that play for you here. Everything's all messed up right now. Let's try it again. Okay. So, I on a streak, move him over. Alrighty. Now, watch this here. That's the throw I'm talking about. Over the top to the corner. You have that ability to go home run on that play. Alright, so we can get out of this. We can go into the dice slot weak at this point. Alright, first play we're going to look at is the Broncos China. And I really like this play for short yardage as well. He's got good splits. You're looking at 3 to 5 yards, the B. He beats his man over the middle, gives him some time to move up the field. You know, obviously, if you got somebody like Julio who can take it more than it is, that play is intended for a 3rd and 3 type situation. All right, next play is called PA Bronco Posts. All right, and on this play, you're taking the X receiver, you're putting him on a streak, and you're taking the Y. X on a streak, taking the Y, and you're motioning him to the right. And that's the guy you want to go. It kind of looks like a 3 post to the right, but the Y post is the one that you want to do it. Ooh! Alright, so now the next play we're going to do it 3 different ways. It's called the slot post. Alright, slot post right here. Doesn't look like a, from the play art originally, it looks like it's just a normal play, but we get to use a lot of it. First thing we're going to do is take the RB, streak him, and motion him to the right. Alright. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to hit this A receiver as soon as we can. Right there. Okay. The second way we're going to hit is this RB over the top, because this is the weak spot on the D. Alright. I need some more real estate there. But, I'll show you that we can make it work. Alright. Kind of reading the high low on this here, and first you got the A on the short. If the RB gets covered, then it's the Y that you want to go to. So that's what, this is where the RB doesn't get covered. That's your initial read. If the RB does get covered, then you're dumping it off to the Y receiver. So let's go ahead and show that to you again. The RB is not getting covered, we're gonna throw it to him. That's what I was trying to show you before, as far as depending on how that guy reacts. So let's go ahead and see if we can get to where he was reacting before, where he jumps to RB and we get the Y open. Okay, yeah, so he stayed a little bit further back. Now you're throwing it to the Y. And that's how you run that play, okay? Next play is going to be the Broncos fake rub. And what you want to do on this play is take A and streak him. Move him to the left. That's going to give you the ability to do this quick throw to Y. There's your streak. Right there. And that's just one of those, you know, you need 4 or 5 yards on the play and you get that there. The other way is you take your RB, you block them, you take your A, put them on a curl, and then you wait for your Y to clear, and you get them over the top. So obviously you want to keep your running back in for extra time. Alright, next play is called the Broncos Mesh. You want to put your running back on a block on this play, and then you want to run the rest of the play as is. And you're going to hit the in pattern. I didn't put my running back on a block, but still see that's where it's going to go. I just put him on the block because he doesn't do anything for the play. You might as well give him the opportunity to give you some more time. Now we're going to go to a play called short post, but we're going to go ahead and put it flipped before we get to the line of scrimmage. Here's the short post, put it flipped. All right. So you're going to take the A, put him on an in, and that's going to be able to get this X receiver open. right there. And then do the same exact thing, and you get the post open right there. Alright, let's go to the X under next. Alright, on the X under, we're going to do it first the Y streak and motion the A right. Alright, so that's going to be the setup. And the first thing we're going to do is get our short yardage to the X receiver after he clears out with that streak. Right there, get your 5 to 6, get your first. Now, we did the streak, and we did the this so we could do it two different ways here. So you move him over. You put your Y, put your Y on a streak. That's going to open up that A right in that seam route for cover 3. Alright. That guy made more of a play than I want him to, but we're going to go ahead and show it to you with a little bit more pass lead to the inside. Alright, there it is. Alright. Next play is going to be called X follow. We're going to run this two different ways, but both ways are going to be the same setup. On the X follow, you add X follow, there it is. Gonna motion A to the right. Now, just want to show you, it does work the same way. Let's get back to here. On the comeback and streak combination to the right side. But you want to bullet it down again. Right there. And then the second way you're going to do it is same thing as before, and you're going to hit that seam. Try it out again here. You want to hit that seam where that's really, really soft. And remember to the inside. Come on there, Levine. Make a play for me, buddy. Hopefully your tight end's a little bit better, but that's the soft spot that you can hit in the cover 3. Alright, so now we're on number 101 on the guide. We're going to be looking at the curl flat play. Alright. Curl flat, we're going to take the Y, put him on a slant. That's going to give you a little bit more of that trail that we like to throw right here. Throw it early, get yourself those yards. Next play we're going to look at is the double cross flipped. Okay, here's a double cross. Now we're going to flip it. And we're going to go ahead and run the defense, or to put Y on a streak, block the RB. Now, you can block the A, or you don't have to block the A, it's optional. But there's the throw that you're trying to make here. That time I had enough time, that was without blocking him. Let's go ahead and show it to you with blocking him. And you can easily do this by just pressing the max protection. But that's that throw. Alright. Next play is going to be called the PA cross, sticking in the dice slot weak. And we're looking at the PA cross. On the PA cross, you want to take the X and streak him, motion him right. and we're going to be hitting two different times. First one, we're going to hit the A. You can see there, we just made our own four verticals type play. And this A was really very unique, same type way as the four verticals would be. It's got that type of post. It's not like a normal post. And the second time you do it is basically same thing. Put your X on a streak, move him over on that four verticals type. You'll get that guy in the slot open a lot of the times. In the middle. Alright. So, as you saw in that play, that free safety jumped on that post, and that what's happened. You kind of read who you want to throw it to, but that guy's open a lot. Alright, next play. It's going to be the corner strike. On the corner strike and take your RB, block him. Motion your X to the right. And you're going to hit your X receiver once it makes that cut inside. Alright. Then we're just going to take Y, put him on a streak. That's also going to free up your X receiver. Alright. Next thing we're going to do is show you another screen and how to make it work. This is going to be very similar to the way we did the last one. But not all screens we do the same exact way. So this one we're going to take the X. And we're going to put him on a curl. And motion him to the right. That's going to give you enough room to catch this and get upfield with the B. Alright. Like I said before, if we don't do it that way, this is the type of open thing. Those guys come in a little bit more. What you're trying to do is keep that strong safety number 32 off of you. I'll show it to you again. And by doing this curl, it keeps him in his place. Everybody backs off, and now you've got a lot more room to have some open field running. Alright? So that's all from the gun dice slot. Now we're going to go to the gun wide trips halfback weak. First play we're going to look at is the stick. Sticks get that unique route on the right side where the guy gets by his guy very easily for the touchdown. But also what we're trying to do is take your running back, put him on a streak, and we're going to try to get it to him once he clears. Right there. Alright, next thing we're going to do is the PA wide receiver in. And you've seen this a couple times in different formations already, but it works everywhere. You're going to put your RB on a streak, A on a slant, do your play action, throw it when you got a chance right there for the end zone. Alright, also it works on the sideline. B on a streak, A on a flat, and you're going to hit the RB receiver to the right side, right there. Alright, next play we're going to do is the slot clear out. I'm going to run this three different ways, very similar setups though. Here's your slot clear out. First way it's going to work for you, you're just going to block your running back. You're going to hit Jones on the inside, get yourself your first down, and some more depending on how you throw the ball and who you got. Second time is the same thing, but you're actually going to hit Douglas. So put your running back on there. Douglas on this deeper in, kind of the levels right there in the middle. And your last way is you're going to go ahead and you're going to streak your X receiver. And then you're going to go ahead and motion your RB to the left. And You're gonna be able to get this out with the RB here. Oop. Let's try this again. Anytime you see this deep out route, it really does well against most coverages as far as getting deep enough into the sideline that you're gonna be able to throw that ball if you motion him to the sideline. So he just takes that inside release, then he goes right there, and you got him to the sideline. Alright. Next play is called the FL short dig. You're going to run this as is. And the way you're going to run it is you're going to throw it to Jones as he makes his break inside. Right in the middle. Alright. Next play is going to be the slot crossing. And you're going to do the same thing as is. We're going to run this two different ways. One's going to be regular, one's going to be flipped. So here's the regular. You're gonna throw it to. Ooh. That was a different coverage because I pressed it wrong. I didn't even look at it. So here's the slot crossing. And you run as is, you're gonna hit that cross. As soon as he crosses that middle linebacker, throw it up a little bit. Get more yardage that way. And the second way, we're going to do it the same way, but we're going to flip it. And you're going to look at that route on the right-hand side. This book has a lot of those routes where you're going to be able to beat that inside and just your lob in it. The guy never recovers once he gets the inside release. All right. Next play is going to be called the deep in zig. Alright, right there. On this play, you're going to put both the B on a fade and the A on a fade. And that's going to be able to get that Z, that seam route open. Right there. He got bumped and he got held up a little bit, but let's try it again here. The A on a fade, the B on a fade. Right, that time he doesn't get held up as much. But I'm staring at him and not at the defense. Let's try this again. Be on a fade. You can see how he's going to be open. We just got to get the ball to him. Right there. Right. On this play, your post. If you throw it flat, cut it off, he'll be open as well. Alright. Next play is going to be the corner strike. You're just going to put the RB on a streak on this one. Where are we? Corner strike. There it is. Corner strike. You're just going to put your RB on a streak. Right there. Next one's going to be the curl flat. You're going to put the RB on a streak on that one. This is one of those, just looking for about 7 to 9 yards. Put your RB on a streak. You're going to be hitting your B receiver on this curl flat route. Once it does that, throw it right there. You have the ability to turn it upfield if you throw it, right? Alright, so the next play is going to be level switch. I like the way this route combination is as is. Alright, in this play you're going to be able to throw it to your tight end as soon as he breaks. He's going to be having that in route. So you don't want to hesitate right there. Right, it just splits everybody. Alright. Next one's going to be the strong flood. on a strong flood play. This route combination beats cover three very well. It's the deep out, the flat, and the streak. You throw that to the sideline. All right. Next play is going to be slot drive. We're going to throw this to two different people here. On the slot drive, where are we here? Okay. First person you want to look at is that B receiver. That outside, he just gets torched to the corner. Alright, it's a fade route. Look at the uniqueness of it. It's an outside step. You see it right there? And then if you just pass lead it to the corner. I'm running out of real estate because I'm trying to throw it too far. But that you want to look at that for a bomb play. And then also right here, all you're looking for in this one is the in to the A once it clears. Kind of like the levels, it's right there. Throw it right on his break. Alright, so now we're going to show you a wide receiver screen and what we like to do with it. We're going to turn this into a different type screen. Okay, so we're going to take the B, put him on a streak. We're going to take the Y, put him on a swing. But we're also going to motion him to the right, so he's on this side. And we like the way this gets set up a lot more. I totally just got caught up in that animation. He was doing a stutter step. I'll show this again. So put him on a swing right, move him this way. Kind of slows down and he comes flat, if you see that. And I, again, spun instead of done it. So let me see if I can get this to be a little bit more successful. Because you want your screens to have the home run potential. Stops, goes flat. Now you got three guys there. My wide receiver's just passing up on that guy as far as blocking him. I gotta get up. What I would suggest, if you got a good blocker, like Roddy White's a better blocker than Harry Douglas, maybe put him out there. But as he gets flat, that's more of your home run type if you read your blocks a little bit better. Alright. But I like the way that screen ends up being on that play when you run it that way. Alright, so the next play we're going to look at is the Y shallow cross, but we're going to flip it before we get to the line of scrimmage. So the Y shallow cross is right there. We're going to flip it. And we're going to go ahead and only adjustment is we're going to put B on a fade. And what that's going to do is get that post open. Right there in the middle. Alright. Next play we're going to do is the Bronco seam. And we're going to get our slot receiver Douglas here in the seam on this play. There's the Bronco seam. There he is. This is a good route to attack cover three on. It's the inside of the seam, and you got the A kind of keeping everybody at bay. So you throw it really quickly right there on the seam route, and he should be open for you. Now, the same play, flip it. You're going to have that comeback and a streak type combination. What you want to do is just go ahead again, bullet it down, and you'll be able to beat cover three all day that way. All right. So that is basically all the gun trips halfback week. Now we're going to go into the gun bunch week. We'll finish up this portion of the video on this formation, and we'll pick up on gun snugs on the next video. So let's go ahead and go to fun week. First play we're going to look at is the bunch trail. On the bunch trail, we're going to take A, put him on a streak, and we're going to put B on a curl. I feel that's your best way to get the RB open in space so he doesn't have to catch it in traffic. Right there kind of clears it all out and gets you your first down that you're looking for in short yardage situations. And then the next thing you can do is take your B, and motion him to the right. Let's try this again because I messed up on that. I changed this route. Okay. Take B. Motion him. Right is right, and I don't know why I keep on going left. Alright, so B. Motion him to the right. He's going to do this drag stop. Alright. And he's going to be wide open, and you're going to catch it, and you're going to be able to kind of, it's kind of like, almost like a middle screen. Now you have the ability to get upfield. This works really well when we're trying to get short yardage plays. I'll show it to you again. And everybody's covering down the field. They're going to be covering that trail route. It looks like it's a drag. Then he just stops. You catch it. But this play gives him the ability to get it up the field. So in this video and in my guides, I like to show you plays to get first downs for short yardage. I can beat you down the field all day, but if you can't move the chains on short yardage, it's not great. The last thing on this, you take your B, put him on a streak, and you motion your A to the left. And this post will be open for you. RB is going to cook out, and then you put the post to this side. Alright, next play we're going to look at is the bunch curl. We're going to run this a couple different ways as well. It's called the Broncos curl, my bad. And what we're going to do on this play is we're going to take the B, put him on a fade. And then we're going to take the X, put him on a streak. Alright, that's going to, first thing you're going to do is, B is going to get lost in the shuffle here, and you're going to be able to beat him deep. Because he takes that inside release, and gets lost in the shuffle, and he's able to beat the guy over the top on that play. Now, we do the same exact setup, and we'll be able to hit our curl route for a more safe throw right there. And then the next thing we could do is a different setup here. We'll take your RB, put him on a streak, put your X on a comeback, and make sure you block your running back. And this time we're going to go to the post route for the big long home run type play. Alright, so the next play we're going to do is the halfback cross screen, but we're going to run this a little bit differently than most people do. And on this halfback screen, what we're going to do is we're going to take the Y receiver, we're going to motion him to the left, and then we're going to drag him. Right? And this is going to be more of a middle screen for you. Now that's the way you do it with a drag. You can also do it where you don't put him on a drag. Oh. You keep him on his route and he'll stop like a true middle screen. But a lot of times what happens is the linemen get in his way. That's why I don't do it that way. He stops. And now he's got that ability to get upfield. I just don't think, I kind of like it one continuous action. So that's why I put him over here, put him on a drag, move him over to the left. Throw it. You want to throw it behind your lineman. You can see there I didn't do it. I was trying to talk at the same time. So go ahead and throw it. When I mean behind my lineman, I don't mean like towards the line of scrimmage. I mean like before he gets to his lineman. Okay, so before he gets to his lineman, he catches it. And I'm not timing that the way I want to time it, but that's basically the middle screen. I'd like to show it to you a little bit better than this. Okay, that's a little bit better. So that's how you would run the middle screen. or the halfback cross screen. I mean, next play we're gonna look at is the Bronco cross. We've got four different ways we want to run this play. Show you the first setup here. Broncos cross looks pretty simple of a play, but show it to you right here. Just that, but we're gonna show it a couple different ways. First way we're gonna do is take the RB. We're gonna put him on a slant. We're gonna put the A on a hitch. And we're gonna motion this guy to the right. Alright, that gives the B receiver nice splits, and he's gonna be able to beat this man inside by keeping that guy there. Second way we're gonna do it, just simply put your RB on an in and keep him bunched like that, and then you could be able to hit your B when he crosses the middle of the field. The third way, get my numbers right. We take the B, we're going to motion him left, and he's going to stay on this route, but watch, he's going to beat his man on that sharp turn. They can't get there. Okay, that's how you get that out there. In the same way, you're going to take the that's just the same type deal. There's just the three ways. My last one, I put the wrong play down. It's probably the next play. Alright, so those three options for the Bronco cross. And then we're going to go ahead and do the next play is going to be the corner strike. On the corner strike, you want to take A and put him on a streak. That's going to free up your B right away. And if you pass lead him up, you can keep him going up. Second way is to put the A on a streak and motion B to the left. And you get the post route open to B once he clears over the top. Alright. Next play we're going to look at is the Z spot dig. What I like about the Z-spot dig, it's a delayed route to the B, but you could throw it to him right when he's going there, and it almost turns into a delay slant. Stop, throw it to the delay slant, and let him go. You don't have to wait for him to stop, and I think that's what I like about this play. You run it as is, you stop, as soon as he goes, throw it to him. And you'd be able to get, you know, it's a safe slant type play because everybody backs up, now he throws it, and he has that one receiver in front of him. I mean, because the way it intended is, this guy's going to go, he's going to stop, and then you turn it upfield, which works, don't get me wrong, but I like the way the other way is a little bit better, where you throw it right here as a slant type, and it's a real safe route when you need short yardage. Alright, next play is going to be the divide. Number 143 on your play call sheets. And on the divide play, great if I was in the right formation. Alright, divide play, keep it as is, and I really like this play because it has an inside wheel right here to the RB receiver. And he just goes right there. You want to pass lead a little bit more to the inside. That guy made a nice play by cutting it off. He usually isn't that close. Goes in. Ooh. Let's try this again here. Takes the in. That's more like it right there. Of what you're going to see. You can definitely, to get more spacing, you can move this guy to the right. Get that guy more out of the play. You can also put him on a fade to get him away from it. but you do want to throw that inside. I totally whiffed on that ball. Let's try it again here. So it takes the inside cut. That's where you want to throw it. Alright. So next play is going to be the clear out SE opt. And this play is a nice play for your tight end as well. It clears out like the play suggests. And it's a deep post. If you look at it as a player, that's what looks like how deep that post is. And you'll be able to put the A on it in to keep those linebackers short. And then just throw it, because that free safety has to make a decision, and he's got to go either to the deep guy or that guy, and you could just throw that ball flat. Alright, so we got a couple more plays here in Gun Bunch before we wrap up this video, before we start the next one. This play is going to be called Close Bronco Cross. So the close Bronco crosses here. What we want to do on this play is we want to put X on a streak. And we're going to hit B. Takes that inside release. Then we just throw it over the top. That inside release, he takes an outside release but gets inside of his man, if you want to watch it again. I put X on a streak just to keep that guy honest on the left hand side. Takes the inside right there, and you're just putting it over the top. Oh, that's a bad throw, but we're gonna still go. This is a play that you want to have more yardage on. If you can see that, I'm trying to throw this pretty short. See how he does the inside release, and it's right there. Okay, and then also what you can do is do a hitch to B. Watch this. This is just one of those short plays again. Doesn't look like much, but everything clears out. He just chills. Actually, that was not the way I wanted it. Get down. Let's try this again. B, he clears out. That guy is staying closer than I want him to. Let's try this again. My first lab session, he just stayed there. And that, you know what I need to do? I need to put the A on a streak. And force him. The A will get open if that strong safety tries to bite on the hitch, which is a great scenario, but I'm trying to get. So now he didn't bite on the hitch, now we got that easy yardage. So again, another one of those third and three plays where put the A on a streak, do the hitch, and just get that easy play. Alright, so the last play of this video, number 2, number 147 on the guide, is going to be called the Close Mesh. And on Close Mesh, we're just taking advantage of this one route combination that gets open very easily against cover 2. But you put the A on a streak, and it's going to go to the B receiver. And I ran out of real estate there, but let's throw it again here. So what I like to do is, when he comes up, kind of throw it to his back shoulder there, instead of to the sideline. If you do that, one, you'll get more yards, two, you keep him in bounds. So he goes to the right, and then he throws it up there, keep him in bounds. I know it doesn't look like that you want to throw that ball if you look at the safety. Why would you throw it? But he's still in his back pedal. He can't react to that type of throw. So guys, that was video number 2 of the Broncos playbook guide. We're going to continue on play 148 with Gun Snugs on the next video, trying to keep these videos rather equal on the next video.